Let me show you my Bibles. I only have two Bibles. First of all, you're not going to see a picture of me. I've got nothing to do with my Bibles. I'm showing you my Bibles, not myself. On YouTube, you'll often see these Bible enthusiasts showing off their Bibles, and they're rolling the leather and talking about grain and talking about this and that. And they don't even care if the italicized words have been made straight. Oh, but the leather is so nice. Oh, but it's R.L. Allen and it's handmade in Scotland and it cost so and so much. I will give you to understand, I will tell you, the only holy thing in the Bible is the words. The Bible is not about bookbinding. The Bible is about the words of God. This one is from the Trinitarian Bible Society. You'll notice it says just Holy Bible. It doesn't say King James Version. It just says Holy Bible. And like I said, it has a hard cover. What's that? What's the cover got to do with the Bible? Nothing. The Bible is the Word. We love the Word. We don't love leather. We don't sit and smell leather. That's not loving the Bible. We love the Word and we love the words. Just as they came from God's translators in 1611, even with the italicized words, they're shown. So, this one is, well, both of them are the Cambridge text. Both of them have been purchased from AV Publications, Gail Ripplinger. The Holy Bible, containing the Old and New Testaments. Produced by Cambridge University Press for the Trinitarian Bible Society. Large print text edition. And I like my Bibles to be text only. Text only. I want no notes, no marginal notes of any kind. No stupid Schofield notes, no way. You're not going to impose your doctrines on me. I will let God teach me his doctrines. And I can have doctrinal books. Oh, I can have hundreds of them. I will keep them on the shelf. And I will keep God's words pure. And man's words don't belong in the Bible anyway. This is God's words. They're big. They're well printed, they're clear, crisp, crisp and clear, bold. You see, if you treat your Bible well, it will last. I've had this one for 5 years. It's not falling apart. And it isn't top quality bookbinding. That's not the issue. That's not the issue when it comes to the Bible. The issue is, have you got the right text? And I will tell you that the Cambridge text is the right text. The Oxford text has about 12 mistakes in it. I will not have a Bible that has 12 mistakes in it. I'll show you one. Just one difference. I don't want a Bible with one mistake in it. And I believe, I know, that God has a Bible on the earth that is perfect. It is the Cambridge Standard text that is perfect. If we go to 1 John 5, chapter 5, verse 8. Here it says in the right text, "For there are three that bear witness in earth, the Spirit with a large S, and the water and the blood, and these three agree in one." If I'm not mistaken, the Oxford text has a lower capital S, has a lower case S there. It's supposed to be a capital S, and that's what it is in the Cambridge Standard text. You see, I love the Bible for the word's sake. It wouldn't be any worse if the book was Highland goatskin and glued, you know, strengthened underneath here and everything and I would roll the leather up. Look, the book lays flat. This one lays flat also. It lays flat. A book is made for reading. It's not made for carrying and showing off and smelling and stroking and holding. It's made for reading. I read mine. This is the one that I use for reading. And this is the one that I use for studying. It's got a wide margin. This is also the Cambridge text. It's produced by another producer. It's called Anthony. See, it says authorized King James. It does not say King James Version. The King James Bible is not a version. The King James Bible is not a version of the Word of God. It is the Word of God. Every other so-called Bible is a version. Every other so-called Bible is a version, even the New King James Version. And they are versions of the perverted text, even the New King James. The New King James departs from the King James text in over 1,200 places in the New Testament alone. That's not the Holy Bible. This is the Holy Bible. So I use this one for studying. And when I'm studying, I study the text and I write notes in the margin and I use colors. I use seven colors. Red is the blood. Red is God the Father. Red is salvation. Blue is the Word. Blue is Jesus and anything that refers to Jesus. Yellow is the Holy Ghost. Green is prayer. Orange is the power of God and healing. And purple is Israel. And brown is death and the devil. And so on. Yes. That's the way I've studied the whole Bible through. And I like to draw little pictures. The judgment seat of Christ. That's Christ sitting on his judgment seat. I like to draw little pictures to help me find and remember things. Yes. Only the words of God. No other word is allowed. But of course, this is my study Bible, so I can write my own study notes. But they are my notes. Not Schofield's notes or anyone else's. Nope. No way. No way, Jose. So this is these are my two Bibles. And you may ask, what about the cover on this one? How about the binding? Oh, it's plastic or something. Feels just like it's not genuine or anything. Doesn't even smell like leather. It says genuine leather. That's, I think that's just something that they write. They always write genuine leather, even when it's not, well, that's not very honest. But you hold the Bible, and it's God's book, and you love it because God speaks in it and through it. So you read his word, and you love it, and you keep it in your heart, and you are a doer of the word. Oh, I love the book, but I love it for the word's sake. I don't love it for the niceness of the book. We're not about bookbinding. Give me a break. We're not here about Highland goatskin and Indian paper and what have you. This and that and the other. That's stupid, utter stupidity in my estimation. And I see on the internet, on YouTube, you know, they're talking about long primer. And it's such a terrific Bible from R.L. Allen in Scotland. And they talk about the leather and the smell and the size and the proportions. And oh, it's so well made. It would only be perfect if it had the italicized words. Since they make the italicized words straight, they have changed the text as God has given it to us through his translators under King James in 1611. They made words in italics to show where they had of necessity added to the text for the sentences to make sense. That's why they did that. And since R.L. Allen makes all the words in regular type and removes the italicized words, it is no longer a perfect King James Bible. So forget about your leather and your Indian paper and what have you. It's nonsense. It's rubbish. Rubbish. And 5 years ago, I bought another Cambridge Bible. It had a concordance and it had notes and things in it, you know. It had about 200-300 pages of notes, explanatory notes. And I was reading these notes, and then I was reading about Lucifer. And he was correcting the Bible, saying that there was a mistake in the text of the Bible and it should rather be Morning Star. I couldn't love that Bible. I couldn't hold that Bible. It felt dirty. It felt polluted. It felt profane. Men's words in the Bible telling me that the words of the Bible are not correct, I will not have that. So I tore the page out of that Bible and put it in the bin. But then I was reading more and more notes and stuff, and it was just, all these notes were just ridiculous. So I threw the Bible away. I didn't want a Bible like that. No way. So, and this Bible here, It has got nothing in the back, just the end, and that's the end. And if I go into a Christian bookstore or I look through Christian books and Bibles, and I see Bibles that call Israel Palestine, then that is blasphemy. So if I look through a Bible and I see they say they call Israel Palestine. It's a profane piece of paper. It's just leather and paper. It's not worthy to be called a Bible. Here I have a Bible from Gail Ripplinger. It is the right text. Every word in this Bible here is like every word in this Cambridge Standard Text Bible here. And these print plates are from the 1920s. They have not been changed. They have been perfected and perfected and perfected. They have changed and you know, where spelling mistakes have been, they have replaced words. You can even see it in some places that they have fixed these printing plates, and these printing plates are without mistake. They're perfect, just perfect. And this Bible is set in accordance with that one. It's the same text, Cambridge Standard Text. And I was talking about the maps. The maps in this one, I looked through it, you see. If it had said Palestine, where it's Israel, I would have cut these maps out and I would have burned them. There's no stupid nincompoop going to pollute my Bible over my dead body. Here it says, the Holy Land in the time of the kings. The Holy Land, now that is something, the Holy Land during our Lord's ministry. You see, even when Israel was fallen and not, it was occupied by the Roman Empire and they called it Palestine, it's still God's Holy Land, and it has never been, it will never be Palestine. It will always be the Holy Land. And when the Jews are there, when their state, when they have a state, when they have a country, it is called Israel. And their capital is Jerusalem. Tell the Pope I said so. Jerusalem in the time of Christ. So if you call it the Holy Land, just call it the Holy Land, that's perfect. Because it always is and always will be the Holy Land. It is God's land. Beulah land. Beulah land. Praise the Lord. And now I will show you that I have translated the King James Bible into Faroese. And I have, how have I done it? Oh, I'm a graphic designer, and I know fonts, so I have looked at this font, I've studied everything in it, and the proportions, and I've counted the lines, and I've counted the letters, I've measured everything, even measured the distance between there and everything, and so I made it just exactly the same. This Bible is the same size as this one. Of course, this is printed on A4 paper, so it's a little bit bigger. And my King James Bible is now being printed in America. And it will be just like this. The paper and everything, the proportions and everything, will be just like this Cambridge Bible. And you ask, oh, how will the binding be? Who cares? It has nothing to do, it is irrelevant. It's the word of God that matters. See? The Gospel according to Saint Matthew. Evangelii sambart Sankt Matthäusi. Dot. Chapter 1. Everything is the same. Even this capital letter there, it goes down another row. It's just the same there, see? Just goes down another row. And the numbers, it goes in a little bit, and then comes the number, and then it goes in a little bit. No full stop there. And just the same here. Goes in a little bit. See that? And if you study, for example, the number, 17, you see that the 7 comes down there, and the 16, the one is a little lower than the 6. The 6 goes up a little bit. That's just exactly like it is here. It goes up and the seven goes down. See that? And then I've been through all this, pronunciation marks, all of them. Faraz and Zara. And it is also here. Faraz and Zara. Everything. I've been working on this for 7.5 years. 6 to 7 hours a day, and on Saturdays and Sundays, maybe 10 to 12 hours for 7 years, and now it is finished. It's the word that's holy. Everything else is man-made. Of course, everything else should be first class. If it can be, then that's good. But if you compromise on the word and the word is not perfect, then you don't have a perfect Bible. Highland goatskin and Indian paper doesn't recompense for mistakes in the word. It's the word that's holy. It's the word that's important. And then I have gone twice through the text with my finger like this. And I have found words that are in italics. See, there's no word yet in italics. No word yet. But there it is. That had been the wife in verse 6. Sum heye vere kona. You see, those words are in italics. Also in my translation. If we look further down here. Verse 12. And after that they were. After that, see, in verse 12, and after they were brought to Babylon, you see, in English, they don't say after that they were, but in Faroese, we would say after that. We have to put that in between there, and I have put it in between there in my translation, and since I have put it there, I have put it in italics to show that that word is added. That's a sign of honesty. You can be dishonest if you want, but I'm going to be honest. Here's a word, for example. Are 14 generations. Are, in verse 17. Here, carried away, are 14 generations. Are is in italics. So I've been through very slowly the whole Bible and done those things. Was a just man, verse 19. Ver ein rattvísur mervur. Mervur is man. So this is, it's just exactly the same. I've done the translation word for word. Dum, 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 dum. Initially, word for word, but then I read it again through in just Faroese, studying the text, just thinking about the meaning. Is it correct? Does it make sense? And then, if necessary, then I have made it make sense. I have changed it so that it is correct, only if necessary. But initially, it is very, 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 very much like the King James Bible. Not just like it, it is identical. Identical. Holy Bible, this is the Old Testament. Faroese King James, containing the Old and New Testament. This is my 11th. Correction, and the last one. This was the last one. Last time I went through the text. I also had a good proofreader here in the Faroe Islands who went 3 times through the Old Testament. This is the book of Exodus. There you have the name of God. It is Jehovah. It is not Yahweh or any other rubbish. It is Jehovah. Jehovah. That's his name. Keep all your blasphemous nonsense to yourself. The Bible is the King James. The Bible is the Cambridge Standard Text, Standard Image. The Bible is the Word of God. It has nothing to do with leather and bookbinding. That's ulterior. Secondary, that's totally, totally secondary. Absolutely secondary to the issue. The issue is the word. Have you got the right word? I will not be buying the Oxford text. I will not be buying Jehovah with an H in the end. Jehovah, seven letters. Jehovah, seven letters. Yes. I will not be buying books from R.L. Allen where the text is altered. I will not be buying Oxford King James Bibles with 12 mistakes in it. No matter what leather they produce them with, and no matter where how nice the paper is and how nice the cover is, oh, you can roll it like this and it goes back out again. Wow! Oh, that's worth $200. No, it's not worth anything if they have corrupted the word. You can flush it down your toilet. That's what you can. Give me a pure, unadulterated King James Bible with the words perfectly printed, and I have a Bible. And then keep your words, the words of men, keep them to yourselves. Don't put one word of man in the Bible. I haven't printed one word. I haven't made one single note about anything. I have chosen the correct translation of every single word in the Bible in accordance with the King James. One word at a time. One word at a time. Two words at a time. And also, whenever there are sayings, special sayings, like, for example, they cast the same in his teeth. That's an expression. Then I study what that expression means, and I see if I can word it the same way in Faroese. If that doesn't work, then I choose something that is as close to that as possible. As possible. Here we have two Bibles, so-called. Alexandrian perversions, if you ask me. Not only if you ask me, I know they are. There are two Alexandrian perversions of the Bible that have been printed, published in Faroese during the 20th century. This is the one that I got from my grandmother when I was 15. I used this one for 21 years, but it is the wrong text. It is Alexandrian. It is comparable to the Revised Version. It's comparable to the Douay Rheims. This is a Catholic Bible. It's full of mistakes from cover to cover. I don't love that one anymore. I don't use it anymore. I use my one. Because I know myself, since I have made it myself, that is, it is 100% like the King James Cambridge Standard Text. I keep talking about Cambridge Standard Text. What text is that? Well, it's the pure Cambridge edition. The pure Cambridge edition. You can see here, I have stroked out three words of men here. It says, writes in the authorized King James. That's correct. But here it says, authorized King James version of the Bible. The King James is not a version, it is the Bible. So it should say here, rights in the authorized King James Bible are vested in the crown. That would be correct. Version of the Bible makes every perversion justifiable, and they are not justifiable. They are of Satan. Here it says, the image of the large print text edition is the property of Cambridge. See, this is an image. It is this image. It is fixed. Since the printing plates are fixed, they are not changed. These plates are stored in Cambridge, in the Cambridge printing press, and they will not be reset. They use these old printing plates to print this Bible still. And now I know also that these exact pages have been photocopied or scanned, I don't know, with permission by church Bible publishers in America. And they're printing Bibles wherein the pages are exactly like the pages of this Cambridge Standard Text. That's good.